As we've been discovering, the Bernina 790 truly lets you set up the machine for the way you sew, and in the embroidery side, for the way you embroider. So a quick little run through of the settings that would be globally applied to any parts of your embroidery side of your machine can be found in the settings area. So when you're here, touch the hoop picture. So again, these are things that are only applied once you're on the embroidery side of your machine. So what are we talking about? Some of these do have where you can touch the question mark and touch the actual item for a definition. I say some of them because they don't actually all have a definition, but here's where we would adjust the tension. So if you're always noticing that your top tension needs to be loosened, you could come here and kind of get that all the way to be as low as a -1 or a -2 when you are embroidering. So you could set that for like your thinner bobbin thread that you might be using, and then it will remember it for your embroidery. Adjusting the speed would be this particular one. This one, I will have to confess, centering the embroidery motif, I'm not exactly sure how this is used just yet. I know Bernina puts a lot of things in here, but I haven't actually needed to use this one just yet. It is different than the next one. This one would be how to calibrate your embroidery hoop so it actually matches up with the template right there in the center of the hole. So if you needed to, you can actually get that adjusted. I'm not going to put the hoop on, but that's how it'll walk you through how to actually do it. This next one is actually telling the machine if you're working on something that is a little bit thicker, so a thicker fabric, a much higher fleece. I've even needed to tell the machine I'm working on trapunto where that thick area is actually interfering with my foot moving around. So you could actually set that to a higher amount. Next, we have the option for what is called the thread away option. So after it kind of cuts, it moves the needle and kind of pulls the thread away. You can turn that on or off. So if it's not a feature you're looking for, turn it off, but it's actually not a bad thing to have. They've added that recently as it kind of cuts and then pulls and makes sure that that thread comes out of the fabric before it moves on to the next color. Next, some locking stitch features here. So you can actually have those on or off. I am going to say most of the time it's going to be on. There's a time where you might turn it off when you're doing some, say, machine quilting. Next, in the cutting area, do you want it to cut between every color? Do you want to manually hold your threads when it goes to cut? And then also, how often do you want your threads cut? So right now, 6 millimeters is kind of that starting point that if a jump stitch is more than 6 millimeters, it will cut it. You can actually decrease or increase that depending on the type of stitching that you're doing. Last but not least, the option to change it from inches to metric. I will tell you that metric is truly a lot easier to work with. I know in America that doesn't seem right, but it is a lot easier to follow. But if inches are easier for you and you're more comfortable that way, just keep in mind most of your patterns will be noted in metric, and then that way you're not having to like convert them as you go. So just remember, anything that you do in the settings area is remembered after you turn the machine off. So it's kind of a permanent setting until you go in and change it to a different setting of your choosing.